Hi, I'm Malcolm, an embedded software engineer here at SparkFun. Today we're going to be talking about the development tools that you need to get started with MicroPython. If you missed our first video where we discussed what MicroPython is and why we would care, you can check that out here. This video is going to be more hands-on and focused on the actual development tools that you need to get started, so let's get into it. If you remember from the last video, MicroPython is a pared-down version of the Python language and runtime that is well-suited for rapid embedded prototyping and hobby projects. It produces a REPL on a serial interface that allows us to run Python commands directly, but it also exposes a file system and allows us to run entire Python scripts. To run MicroPython on your development board, you will need to load both firmware and software on it. Firmware is specific to a given device, and it handles hardware details and allows you to use the same software on many boards. It is what puts MicroPython itself on your board. Firmware you update much less frequently than software, possibly only once if you want this to always be a MicroPython board. You likely won't need to do any development on the firmware, and it is provided by MicroPython itself or by board manufacturers as pre-built binaries. Software, on the other hand, you change often. It exists as .py Python source files and is where your actual development occurs. In this tutorial, we are going to teach you how to put both firmware and software on your board. There are a few ways to get the MicroPython firmware on your device. SparkFun sells several boards that have MicroPython firmware already on them out of the box, like the IoT Redboard RP2350 and the IoT Redboard ESP32 with MicroPython. For other boards, though, you have to put the MicroPython firmware on the board yourself. One way you can do this is by navigating to the MicroPython Downloads page, downloading the firmware for your device, and following their instructions for installing the platform-specific Flash tool for loading firmware on your board. For example, Raspberry Pi boards use Pico tool or drag and drop, ESP32 boards use ESP tool, and Teensy uses Teensy loader. Another option is to install the SparkFun MicroPython Firmware Updater, which includes the functionality of all of these different tools in one place. Simply select your board, the firmware option that you want, and the physical device port of your board. For firmware, you have the option to flash your device with the latest SparkFun MicroPython firmware from GitHub, or to use your own local firmware file from another source. The Qwiic option for firmware already has drivers installed for MicroPython-supported SparkFun Qwiic devices. When we click Upload, we now have MicroPython firmware running on our board, and are ready to interact with our REPL and upload software. The most direct way that we can interact with the MicroPython REPL is with the MicroPython Remote Control Program, MPremote. Follow the instructions linked below to install MPremote on your system. After it is installed, you can simply invoke it by opening a command prompt and executing MPremote. This will bring up our REPL, where we are free to execute MicroPython commands directly. For example, we can print hello world, do math like 7x7, etc. We also have access to the file system through this REPL. By importing the OS module, we can list the files in the current directory with os.listdir, make directories with os.makedir, change directories with os.changedir, and print the current directory with os.pwd. We can also perform individual commands with MPremote instead of invoking it with no arguments like we did to enter the REPL. To load software to the device, we can perform file operations to copy files onto our board or run them directly using MPremote. Let's create a file that we edit locally with any code editor, and then we can copy it to our board with MPremote CP to run later, or we can run it directly with MPremote run. So let's create a Qwiic Hello World program that prints what platform it's running on. If we ran this with Python on our computer, it would print our operating system or platform, but for MicroPython, it should print the MCU of our development board. I'll create the hello.py file, and then I can run it directly with MPremote run hello.py, and it will run without being copied to the board. Alternatively, I can MPremote CP it onto the board, and then enter the REPL again, and we can see it is now on the board. Then I can execute it by importing it or running exec open read. And now we're running it from the version that we copied onto our board. Another utility provided by MPremote is to use MIP to install software packages directly. If software vendors have MIP packaging for their software, you can install them with the command MIP install. For example, you can install SparkFun's BME280 Qwiic driver simply by typing MPremote MIP install github:// SparkFun/Qwiic BME280 Pi and it will automatically install the software package. And you can find the MIP commands to install Qwiic Python drivers in each of the corresponding Python repos. If you prefer to develop with an IDE, we suggest Thonny or PyCharm. Thonny combines code editing with direct access to the MicroPython REPL and file system. To use Thonny, first follow the instructions linked below to download and install it. Select the board connection at the bottom right of Thonny or in Run Configure Interpreter. Then you can click the stop sign at any time to reconnect to your board and perform a soft reboot, and you will gain access to the REPL in the Shell tab. We can use the shell as before when we were using MPremote, but now we also have a nice GUI interface displaying the file system. We also have access to other niceties like a run button and stop button. So let's click File, New File, and then make a basic Hello World script. Next, let's click File, Save, or Control S, and choose to save this file to our MicroPython device. We'll see our file appear on our MicroPython device, and we can click Run to see the same thing printed out as when we were using MPremote. Finally is an alternative IDE environment called PyCharm. It provides a more modern feel than Thonny, but it requires more manual configuration and setup. Like with the other tools, first follow the instructions linked below to download PyCharm and the MicroPython Tools extension for PyCharm. Then select New Project. Let's name it Hello and leave it as pure Python and all other default settings. Now, let's right-click our Hello directory and select Mark As, MicroPython Sources Root. Next, let's right-click our Hello directory and select New Python File and name it hello.py. I'm going to copy in the same content that we ran for the other two examples that prints the current platform. Now, let's set up the configurations to load and run our code on our board by selecting Current File at the top of PyCharm. Click the plus sign and then select MicroPython Tools, Upload Project, and make sure Reset on Success and Switch to REPL on Success are checked. Next, click Apply. Then we'll click the plus sign again and select MicroPython Tools, Execute. Now let's select the path to our hello.py MicroPython file from before, and again, click Apply and OK to save our configurations. Next, let's navigate to the MicroPython Tools extension in PyCharm. Select the COM port for our board and click the plug icon to connect to our board. Finally, we can select the REPL tab and click the green run button to run our execute job, and we'll watch our script get run. I'll finish by giving a brief demo of just how quickly you can get started with MicroPython Qwiic device drivers by using a combination of the tools that we've talked about today. So we'll start with a board that's initially not even running MicroPython. I'll bring up the SparkFun MicroPython Firmware Updater and plug it into my IoT Redboard ESP32. Then select the correct board and port and the Qwiic firmware option. Now I'll upload it, and then I will have access to all of the Qwiic drivers for interfacing with Qwiic devices. In this case, we'll interface with the new AS7343 spectral sensor that Pete recently demoed. Next, to get the example software for this board, I'll use MPremote MIP install --target github://qwiic-as7343-pi@examples. And finally, I can open the Thonny IDE and connect to my board and select any of the examples that we just loaded and run them directly with the run button. Let's open up example one and take a Qwiic look. We see at the top of this file that the Qwiic AS7343 module is imported. Usually you would have to install that module separately, but since we loaded with the Qwiic firmware option in the firmware updater, it is already available on our board. Scanning through this file, you can see that we are flashing the LED and reading blue, red, green, and NIR values off our sensor and printing them. It is printing in comma-separated format in the order blue, red, green. When I hold it up to a red object, like this RTK facet, we can see the red value in the middle shoot up. So just like that, we have taken a board that wasn't even running MicroPython and have loaded firmware and software and run example code. I hope you found this video a useful introduction for the tools for MicroPython development and that you have all that you need to get started with your first project. Below, you'll find a written guide form of this video, as well as links to the firmware, software, and hardware used. As always, stay safe, be kind, and happy hacking. To the tools for using MicroPython, and that, what? You can run Yeah, I say cut out, no pun intended, okay. And it's an Easter egg if they care.
Good.